countless generations have participated in the tradition and this esteemed institution that is presently called Mount Carmel High School. However, it all began on July 4th and 5th, 1899, as Carmelites gathered in Niagara Falls, Ontario, to adopt the following resolution: to make an application to the Archbishop of Chicago for a parish, college, or day school to which we can send our scholastics. The request was granted on July 26, 1900. Permission was given to erect a school on the south side of the city. The school was first known as the Marshall House.
And eventually we came up to Chicago and originally bought a house on, I believe it was 54th and Harper, might have been 51st and Harper, and that is where the priests who traveled up from Kansas had the first foundation here in Chicago, and they started what they had hoped would be a seminary to train future Carmelites. And very shortly after that happened, they bought a plot of ground at the invitation of whoever was the cardinal at the time, I'm not sure, or the bishop of Chicago, to expand that into a regular high school for boys. And it was at 64th and Star Avenue, which is now Dante Avenue. And that school was called St. Cyril's College. And it was located approximately where the entrance to the new Convocation Center is now. And that building stood, I believe, until the early 1970s. And St. Cyril's College was the original Mount Carmel. And that opened in 1900. So the school has been functioning since 1900. And I believe it was in 1924 that the current main building was constructed. And by then, not only had this area, the Woodlawn community, really become very much an Irish immigrant area, some might even call it an Irish ghetto, but at that point, the kind of Germanic character of the Carmelites had changed from German to Irish because of the young men who were joining the community at that time, particularly from the Chicago area. Woodlawn itself moved from being primarily an Irish immigrant neighborhood. Eventually it turned into a Puerto Rican immigrant neighborhood, and eventually became mostly African American immigrants who either were coming to the United States for the first time or migrating up from the South for better paying jobs that were much more readily available in larger cities.
Cultural changes in the environment, along with many other obstacles faced in the 60s and 70s, would make many question whether or not Mount Carmel would be able to keep their doors open, or for many others, if Mount Carmel would remain where it had been since 1900, in the heart of the Woodlawn community.
The Illinois Central, which was one of the primary ways for our students to get here, had closed the station at 64th Street, and it was through the efforts of Father Dave Dillon that that station was reopened so that our students could use it. And a number of other things like that kept us going pretty well despite some of the odds against us.
Academically, Mount Carmel is often and inappropriately, I think, overshadowed by its athletic success that it's enjoyed. And I think in the minds of some of the people I've met, there's almost this attitude that it's a kind of a zero-sum game, that no school that's so successful athletically could possibly be as successful as Mount Carmel is in preparing young men academically. Mount Carmel continually sends students, graduates, to the top tier of colleges and universities in the United States. And that only is the result of a lot of hard work going back 107 years. which is continually being reevaluated as circumstances change in our society.
From my perspective, the thing that makes Mount Carmel Athletics different than some other places that I've experienced, whether it's the high school I went to or different high schools I've worked at before Mount Carmel, is that in athletics, a huge part of athletics in order to be successful is to be willing to sacrifice. And just coming to Mount Carmel for these students is a sacrifice. Whether it's because they drive 45 minutes to get here, their parents invest and sacrifice to pay the tuition, it's rooted in sacrifice. And I think that the students buy into that immediately. And that immediately translates into athletics. They're willing to sacrifice from the beginning, and when they step on the athletic field, they understand that nothing's going to be just given to them, that they're going to have to work for everything. And likewise, you have students from all over the Chicagoland area, and they really get to form a bond with their teammates because they're all in this together. They're forced to work with one another, and they really buy into that mentality. And I think that's really what makes Mount Carmel different from other places, is the willingness to sacrifice.
One of the things I think is very different is our Mother's Day Mass. I don't know any other school that has Mother's Day Mass. Another thing I think is very nice that Mount Carmel does, and I don't know of any other schools that does it, is our graduating at Mass. Those are the two things that come to mind. Other than the closeness, the family atmosphere here at Mount Carmel.
In my opinion, one of the greatest things about Mount Carmel that is far different from any place I've been around is the diversity. And I think having students from all different walks of life, all different neighborhoods, coming together, making sacrifices is huge. And that when these students go off into the world, whether it's college, the workforce, the military, whatever they happen to choose, that experience they had at Mount Carmel with the diversity, it makes a huge impact.
So the impact of the training and the education and the formation that we receive here at Mount Carmel places graduates in a position, or at least gives them the tools to go out and make a significant difference.
I think with our faculty and staff that the boys learned that they had to do things. It was up to them. We could only, their teachers could only do so much, but so much was their responsibility, and I think they learned the responsibility.
I think that Mount Carmel shapes boys and helps them to become good men with the male faculty members serving as role models. I also think that there's a great sense of letting your emotions show and caring for the boys and helping to push them, but to help them realize why it's so important for them to push themselves and to encourage them to keep doing that and to find their talents and to really pursue what it is that they're good at.
So we're in very good position right now to continue on into another century of serving the church and people who are looking for a good education. And the Carmelites seem to have done that for over 100 years now, and I think with God's blessing and God's grace, we can continue to do that for another 100.